Welcome. Bienvenidos. So we come knowing that we are at grace. We come knowing that we are embraced and welcomed by God's mercy and help. So let us ground ourselves in that love. We make our beginning in the name of God the Father who created us, Jesus, His Son who redeemed us, and the Holy Spirit who sustains and sanctifies us. Amen. Gracious God, have mercy on us. We confess that we have turned from you and given ourselves to the power of sin. We are truly sorry and humbly repent. In your compassion, forgive us our sins, known and unknown, things we have done and things we have failed to do. Turn us again to you and uphold us by your Spirit, so that we may live and serve you in the newness of life through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. God, who is rich in mercy, loved us even when we were dead in sin, and made us alive together with Christ. By grace, you have been saved. In the name of Jesus Christ, your sins are forgiven. Almighty God, strengthen you with power through the Holy Spirit, that Christ may live in your hearts through faith. Amen.
Amen.
Please join us in singing our gathering song, number 645, Christ is Made Sure Foundation.
You have prepared a table before all peoples, and pour out your life with abundance. Call us again to your banquet. Strengthen us by what is honorable, just, and pure, and transform us into a people of righteousness and peace. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior, Lord, let us sit down and listen to the
The first reading from Isaiah 25, verses 1 through 9. O Lord, you are my God. I will exalt you. I will praise your name. For you have done wonderful things, plans formed of old, faithful and sure. For you have made the city a heap, the fortified city a ruin. The palace of aliens is a city no more. It will never be rebuilt. Therefore, strong peoples will glorify you. Cities of ruthless nations will fear you. For you have been a refuge to the poor, a refuge to the needy in their distress, a shelter from the rainstorm and a shade from the heat. When the blast of the ruthless was like a winter rainstorm, the noise of aliens like heat in a dry place. You subdued the heat and with the shade of clouds. The song of the ruthless was still. On this mountain, the Lord of hosts will make for all peoples a feast of rich food, a feast of well-aged wines, of rich food filled with marrow, of well-aged wine, strained clear. And he will destroy on this mountain the shroud that is cast over all people, the sheet that is spread over all nations. He will swallow up death forever. Then the Lord God will wipe away the tears from all faces, and the disgrace of his people he will take away from all the earth. For the Lord has spoken. It will be said on that day, lo, this is our God. We have waited for him so that he might save us. This is the Lord for whom I have waited. Let us be glad and rejoice in his salvation. The psalm, my favorite psalm, the part you say is, you prepare a table before me, and my cup is running over. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. The Lord makes me lie down in green pastures, and he leads me beside still waters. The Lord restores my soul, and guides me along right pathways for his name's sake. Though I walk through the valley, you prepare a table before me, and my cup is running over. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup is running over. Surely goodness shall follow me all the days of my life. Before me, and my cup is running over. Second reading from Philippians 4, verses 1 through 9. My brothers and sisters, whom I love and long for, my joy and crown, stand firm in the Lord. In this way, my beloved, I urge Euodia and I urge Syntyche to be of the same mind in the Lord. Yes, and I ask you also, my loyal companions, help these women, for they have struggled beside me in the work of the gospel, together with Clement and the rest of my co-workers, whose names are in the book of life. Rejoice in the Lord always. Again, I will say rejoice. Let your gentleness be known to everyone. The Lord is near. Do not worry about anything, but in everything, by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God. And the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. Finally, beloved, whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is just, whatever is pure, whatever is pleasing, whatever is commendable, if there is any excellence, and if there is anything worthy of praise, think about those things. Keep on doing the things that you have learned and received and heard and seen in me, and the God of peace be with you always. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
Keep standing, those who are standing, and pray with me the following prayer as we meditate and reflect on the gospel. This is from a Jesuit priest, Pedro Arrupe. Nothing is more practical than finding God, than falling in love, in a quite absolute final way. What you are in love with, what seizes your imagination, will affect everything. It will decide what will get you out of bed in the morning, what you do with your evenings, how you spend your weekends, what you read, who you know, what breaks your heart, and what amazes you with joy and gratitude. Fall in love. Stay in love. And it will decide everything. Amen. Amen. Weddings. Weddings can be
deceiving.
Deceiving. That's a word, deceiving. But I mean chaotic. That's a word. But you know, I often, when people come to me for wedding preparation, I tell them, listen, you just gotta do what you need to do, and then you have to let go at some point. And realize that this is a moment for you to enjoy. Because you cannot control every single detail. And the mother in law will drive you nuts. Sometimes. Whose wedding is Jesus talking about? He talks about the Son being given into marriage. But the gospel writer never talks about the bride. So I ask you, who is the bride in this story? Who is the one allowing himself or herself being chosen? And you know, that points to each one of us. We are the ones who are being called to this party, and we are being bound to the Son, to Christ. And you know, the church has always emphasize that fact. We are wed to God's revelation and God's grace. And in this marriage, we are called to generate life. Now, I have some trouble with the reading. He's referring to the Pharisees and the scribes at the beginning, who seem to be the old guard, who seem to relish the past, traditions, and laws, but they do not have a clue about what's emerging and what's happening at the moment. And they seem to be excluded because they do not want to open their hearts to the now, to the present, to the joy and the experience of life that is taking place within and without. Who is to be chosen? How do we know that we are being chosen? I want to think that God that does not exclude anyone. And you know, there is theological understandings that God, in fact, does not condemn anybody to hell, to that place of gnashing teeth, as the writer tells us, that we ourselves oppose God's presence. You see, hell is not the absence of God, it's the rejection of God. And in that sense, God is ever coming to us, binding God's very self to us and seeking us out. This relentless pursuit of God in our lives. Did you feel that? Do you experience how God is always seeking you out? Do you hear how God prepares the table for you and invites you to dance and have your fill? You know, we can go around life always thinking about the glass being half full or half empty, right? And emphasizing that emptiness and forgetting how God continues to pour God's love in our everydayness. How God continues to seek us out despite ourselves. Listen to the first and the second reading that invite us to really wed ourselves to that reality. A reality that is fused with God. Nothing is outside God. And that's why the prayer is so beautiful when he says that there is nothing more practical than finding God, than falling in love with God. Because it will determine what breaks your heart, who you hang out with, how do you spend your life. It will determine everything. And it will be what makes the difference. So fall in love. Stay in love. Bind yourself to God's love. And then you will find yourself to be chosen. You will be the chosen one. So let us open our hearts to that experience so that we may continue to be infused by God's love. And thus, whatever comes out of us, whatever thought, word, and action will be flowing from that source of God's love and grace. Amen.
Response 10, number 7, 23, and to go to the turning.
Fruit.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
We believe in one God, the Father of all men, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten by the Father, God from God, light from light, true love from true God, begotten not made, of one being with the Father. We love each one here. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate in the Holy Spirit, and the Virgin Mary, and became truly human. For our Savior, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord and the giver of our life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets.
We believe in the Holy Catholic Church.
We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins.
We look at the resurrection of the dead
and the life of the world. Amen.
Amen.
And we come before God knowing that God is always listening to us. So we bring our concerns and our needs. And we pray for those who have died. In a special way, we pray for Kayla's aunt who passed away. For Brian, 26-year-old, who was hit by a car, and his family. We pray for the strength and consolation for those who are left behind. We pray for peace. Peace for ourselves. And that peace may radiate outward from our being to others and change and affect others. Peace for the people in the Middle East, Jerusalem, the Holy City, Israel, the Palestinians, the Ukrainians, all those engaged in turmoil. And for what else do we need to pray? For our youth, for our children, for those seeking refuge, for those seeking safety, for those who are ill in our community, for Angela, for Sam, Aristoteles, Linda, Linda's grandchildren, Michael's family, Gabriel's and Fernanda's family, Mark and Angela's, our families, Kat's family, Jose's, Telmo, the familia de ustedes. Thank you. The promise that all tears will be wiped away, that that shroud of death cast over us will not have the last word. May that promise be fulfilled in our lives. And you know, God, our hearts, our needs, even before we say them out loud or in our hearts. We ask you to listen and to be with us as we make our way back to you. We pray in the name of Jesus, our Savior, our Lord, our friend and companion. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you. Let us share with one another Christ's gift of peace. Vamos a compartir el saludo de la paz. covenant of human life, near to those who suffer, beside the sinner, among the poor, with us, God.
Thank you, Lord.
In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread in his hands, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat, this is my body, given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood shed for you and for all, so that sins may be forgiven. Do this for the remembrance of me." For as often as we eat this bread and drink from this cup, we proclaim the Lord's death until he comes.
Christ died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
And let us pray in the Spirit and in the words that Jesus gave us. Vamos a orar en la oración que el mismo Jesús nos enseñó. Padre nuestro. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us. that your great day has come and jubilee is now.